Hi guys, Nick Jennison from Guitar Interactive. It's Namm 2023, it's only day one and we're all very tired.
Hey, wait a minute, it's day one and a half for me because I did the press thing.
Oh, so that's true.
I did 3 hours of drugs, rock and roll. No, talking and being interviews.
I think we have some Scott Steiner math going on here. We have like we're at the Chapman Guitars booth with the main man, Rob Chapman. Rob, how you doing?
It's nice to meet you, sir.
It's also on the big sign, so it must be true.
Quite honestly, I'm hungover, slightly drunk still, and I'm losing my voice. But that's a good sign.
That's Namm.
It's Namm. Namm is back, baby. Yeah!
Yeah, buddy. So we got a whole bunch of great new guitars from Chapman.
Yes.
We've had the luxury of meeting a bunch of this stuff off camera. Danish Pete is over here wielding a gorgeous butterscotch instrument of terror and doom.
There it is.
Bring it in.
Look at this.
This is the important guitar of the day.
It is. Look at this, the DPT from Chapman. Take that out. What do you want me to say?
tell me how much you love it and why.
I love it because it is, as if I would have to make a guitar like I have now, this is the guitar.
I was going to say you have.
And this is the guitar I would make. So that's just, you know, it is me in a guitar, basically.
I mean, yeah, for sure. I mean, I had the chance to play this in Birmingham. It's a great guitar, man. It's a man's guitar.
Yeah.
Is what it is. It's a very it's a player's guitar. Well, sorry, the microphone was over here, so you can say the T-style word.
The T-style is a man's guitar. And it's got a little man carve here for the grown man. And it's got a cool little carve here for the guy who wants to sit down.
And can I say, I know that, listen, everyone knows that me, Pete, Lee, all the guys, we're all friends. But it was a fucking honor to work with this guy making a guitar. Because he's so good and so specific about what he wants, you know, down to the tiniest detail. We made a number of changes over the whole time period, and we learned a lot as a business. We're better for the process of this guitar, I think.
And I think, I think it'll, you know, and hopefully people will really enjoy it. You know, I know that I will enjoy it. I've got this thing with signature products. I think a signature product, a guy that's his signature product should be using that product. So like I have the Dane pedal, I use it all the time, it doesn't come off my board. And the same with the guitar, it's something that I want to use. And then if people think it's cool, they don't necessarily need to know that it's my signature guitar. They can just go, that's a really cool guitar. They don't know who I am. That's not really that important to me. It's just important that I make something with some guys that I really enjoy hanging out with and working with. And I make something I can put my name on, you know, or put my name onto and go, this is it, and I think people are going to like it.
Nice. I mean, it's a great guitar. I think the best signature guitars, they transcend the person whose signature it is. You know, you have
the
Les Paul. Yeah, the Jam.
The Les Paul, the Jam.
Yeah, dude, 100%. You know, I mean, it's a great guitar, but also it represents kind of a bit of a departure for Chapman because, you know, you guys have always had this very, very modern
Look at the
image. And, 100%, right?
It's a reverse.
Yeah, but this is the first, reverse. But this is the first, like overtly old school vintage Chapman that we've seen.
It's
the start of things to come.
It's the first relic. It's the first reverse headstock. Is it a sign of things to come? I don't know. Chapman has always been evolving and changing. And I think when we have artists come in, they change the DNA.
Mm.
Rabia changed the DNA of Chapman.
Yeah.
Pete is changing our DNA. We are a sum of the parts, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, it just makes me want to make a relic V, to be honest with you.
I can see that. I mean, one of these would look, the Ghost Prep looked pretty cool in relic. I can see that for sure.
I'd love to do some kind of...
Nice. Very cool.
So pleasurable.
Good, man. I'm grinning. It's good. So speaking of signature artists, we have Chris Robertson, which is behind us, Blackstone Cherry.
We have five signature artist products with us today. So DPT is one of them, and it's super amazing. This one is made in England. It's creme de la creme, like Pete, basically.
Yeah.
You know,
cream. Nice.
It's the Danish bacon. It's everything you'd ever want in a T-type, slightly relicked, under the bed finish, whatever you want to call it. But as well as the DPT, we have this. We're super honoured to work with Chris Robertson from Blackstone Cherry.
Buddy.
I don't know whether it's ironic or not, but some of these artists, I've been to see them live. I mean, I've been to see Blackstone Cherry live a bunch of times, screaming, Rain Wizard, at the top of my lungs. And now we're working with him. He's such a lovely guy, honestly. What a phenomenal player, amazing band. This is his guitar.
It's gorgeous, man. I love the white, I love the gold. Very, very cool.
So look, Rosewood is back on the fingerboard. It's an alder body. It's a maple top, maple neck. His Chris's bare knuckles.
Nice. I was going to ask about that because they're not in the Peacemaker livery, but I guess that wouldn't work with the gold because it comes in the peace sign thing.
Yes.
And I was like, are they the Peacemakers?
These are bare knuckles.
Yeah, superb. Excellent.
Yeah, we chatted to the guys. So this is a prototype.
Oh, okay.
But this has the bare knuckles. It's super, super beautiful. And everyone just loves this guitar to pieces.
Yeah, I can see why.
Yeah, so stainless steel frets, loom inlays, all the beautiful woods, but simplicity. It's not like massively over the top like the one strapped onto me.
Yeah.
You know. And so, yeah, we're really happy to launch this. From Lacuna Coil. We've been working with Diego for about 7 years.
Yeah.
He's been one of the main artists that we have using sevens from Chapman. He's always been using our sevens. This is his new signature model and it's beautiful. So sevens are back. We've got 3 sevens this year.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. And yeah, it's great. Absolute monster. And then, down here.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Now, man, this is
the guitar of the hour.
I need to explain this a little bit. I got a LinkedIn message from Styx Zadinia, the drummer from Steel Panther. And he went, hey man, I just bought one of your guitars and it's really, really amazing. And I'm like, oh my God, yeah. I love Steel Panther. I'm out, I must have been to see them 2 or 3 times live, screaming their music. And I said, look, let me send you a guitar. What do you want? And then Michael Starr goes around Styx's house and starts playing his guitar and he messages me, man, the necks feel amazing, I really like them. And we became friends, we start talking, you know, working with them, and then I sort of said, maybe we should make something with both of you.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, because not a lot of people realize that Michael and Styx both play guitar to a high level and write a lot of the work that they do on guitar.
Yeah.
So they needed a studio workhorse. And this is it. The Pegasus.
Nice. I think Studio Workhorse, sure, but it's also sparkly purple.
It's also purple and beautiful, but it is also the world's first double signature.
Oh, interesting.
Yes.
That's pretty cool.
Double signature for Michael and for Styx. Man, they are so lovely to work with. They have such great ideas. It's for the first time for us, it's a short scale length and a hardtail. Pegasus Sentient, Seymour Duncan Infinity Switch.
Yeah,
so you can have any combination of this, whatever you want.
Nice.
Sounds incredible. We had them here playing and jamming, and we had so many people just chilling, watching and enjoying the sounds. I can't get over how good this sounds. They're writing a song for it too. Yeah. I've never had an artist write a song for their guitar.
That's cool, man. Yeah. I mean, it speaks volumes about the guitar, you know, if it makes them want to write a song with it, you won.
Yes.
Right? Because that's what this guitar is for. You know?
Yes, that's right. Yeah, absolutely.
Sure. But so there's one more, if I'm not mistaken.
No, so this is double signature.
Yeah,
that's why it's fine.
Oh, there we go. That makes sense.
So
that makes
Diego, sense. The Chris, the Pete, and then the Pegasus.
Sure.
But
we got this guy as well.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
British workshop, handmade in the UK, super high end spec, creme de la creme. I don't know why we chose to bring a green one, but I guess some people like green ones. Yeah, look at the neck.
That's gorgeous.
Baked bird's eye. It's a proper thick neck too.
Yeah, it's a man's neck.
Yeah. We'll be right back. almost surreal. How sparkly and beautiful this is.
Yeah, it's a great finish, man.
And then, yeah, Ghost Fret's back.
Nice, I was going to say, yeah.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Ghost Fret's taken a hiatus for a few years. We've tweaked and refined little tiny refinements like these carves you see here and bits and bobs that have really just tweaked it until it was perfect. And now, man. The way through too. So nice to play.
Yeah.
I've been playing this for hours, and I will not. I won't stop. I can't stop. It's creamy. Feels great on the hand. It sounds great. I love it. Balances.
Yeah.
I'm wearing a slippery strap,
and it still balances.
We fixed it.
Yeah. Great. That is a big deal.
Well, I say fixed it. For me, it never moved because I always use big straps. But some people thought it had neck dive, so we moved. We improvised with these until we found the perfect place, and now it just...
Nice.
Just hangs. It's a nice feeling to have a guitar that just sits there and...
Shit. Nice. Sounds great, man. Sounds great. Happy days.
This is such a nice show because, you know, Namm is kind of back. It's a little bit quieter than normal. But it's just enough that it feels like Namm's back.
Yeah, I hear you,
man. And I'm loving catching up with all my bros, you know, just the familiar faces, people I work with, people I haven't seen for like 4 years because of COVID.
Yeah.
It's just been so nice hanging out with Rabia, Hannah Bolton, like Zach from Britney Spears, you know, all these people. And it's just been like, shit, let's go get drinks at the bar.
Yeah, nice.
That's what I love about Namm. Yes, we sell guitars, we sell product, and we talk to distributors and dealers, and we do business.
Yeah.
But really, there's a need for bearded, hairy musicians like us to meet together and just kind of go,
yeah, I'm here, man.
Let's chat.
Musicians without beards are also welcome.
Yeah, margaritas, that kind of thing.
Oh, don't talk about margaritas. We've had an experience with margaritas this weekend already.
Really?
But I'll tell you about it later.
Tell me about it later.
Guys, Nick Jennings from Guitar and Graphic Magazine. This has been the Chapman booth, Namm 2023. Rob, it's been a pleasure. Thank you so much for taking the time to share your creamy sustain with us.
You are absolutely
welcome.
It's
been good. We'll see you guys in a little bit.
Okay, guys. Bye.